Having completed her reforestation research after recovering stolen data, Julia headed back to Arizona to meet with a party who had agreed to assist in the realization of her reforestation plans. Waiting for her, there was a prominent Arizona landowner, an old woman who claimed to have the ability to hear the voices of spirits. With the help of the old woman, Julia's reforestation plans were soon back on track. However, when she was about to leave, the old woman made an ominous prediction.
Jin Kazama and Kazuya Mishima must not be allowed to clash. If they are to fight, a sort of great evil will be resurrected and unleashed on the earth, she said.
Julia was skeptical of the old woman's prediction, but after hearing news of the King of Iron Fist Tournament 6 on the flight home, the danger seemed much more imminent. Julia decides to enter the tournament.
This place is just as creepy as I've heard.
We should find the mansion on the far side. I have detected numerous bio readings within.
That's weird. This place was shut down ages ago. What are you people after? Revenge against the G Corporation?
Revenge? The other punks here might have had some kind of bone to pick, but not me. I was just using them.
Using them for what?
Ha! They were just bait to lure in fresh prey like you.
We encountered a man with an intense affinity for battle. His enthusiasm threatens to stimulate my emotion chip. Once we reach the highway that passes through this forest, we will reach a warehouse complex by the harbor. It should serve as an excellent source of information.
Not a very nice place at all, huh?
Bio readings detected in the warehouse ahead!
Over there, huh? Let's go check it out!
This is an awfully small-scale operation to pit against the Mishima Zaibatsu.
You shut up. This is none of your business.
I guess not. You guys won't be around for much longer after all.
How dare you!
A group going by the alias Resistance appears to have taken up residence in the warehouse complex. Their mission objective is the downfall of the Mishima Zaibatsu, though their capabilities appear to be lacking. Now performing perimeter reconnaissance.
Looks like a typical tanker to me.
A large tanker like this is required to anchor offshore for safety reasons. It does not belong in the harbor.
Meaning it's more than it lets on.
Correct. I have confirmed the numerous readings within. Be careful.
Thank you.
Is that a new model?
Yes, its equipment surpasses that of the others you fought.
There's only one, meaning they must still be testing it.
A large number of robots exited the anchored tanker. They appear to be the property of the G Corporation, serial name Jack. These robots made me feel something akin to the human emotion called nostalgia. Most likely just an error in my memory banks.
I could have sworn this harbor was only for ferries.
My research finds that such tankers are not permitted in close proximity to piers.
And that's the tanker if I ever saw one.
My ship. Are you gonna be my new toy?
Wait, this is your ship?
Ooh, I wonder. wonder how you'll sing when I hurt you. I can't wait to find out.
This is giving me a headache.
Anchored in the harbor was a cruiser with the exterior of a tanker. It was piloted by an aesthetically pleasing young female who supplied the keyword Mishima Zaibatsu. She described them as an exceedingly vile organization. Perhaps Lars is also the enemy. I prefer not to consider that option.
This must be where those people in question were spotted.
Yes, a military vessel disguised as a freighter has docked in this area. The personnel in question must be the crew members.
I don't know whose military it is, but I can't imagine they're here for good reasons.
Yeah.
What are you people doing here?
Ellipsis.
Not willing to talk, are you?
The ship anchored in the waterway was a Russian warship. The soldier inside was taciturn and did not cooperate in supplying us with any information. Lars stopped me before I could apply the necessary force. A pity. Area analysis complete. Next destination, the city.